This is the solution to quiz one. Okay, a sketch to understand the motivation for the argument is that consider the interval -1 to 1. And 0 is right in the middle. Then we could select any point that we want and we can call it x. Then the distance from the left end point to x will be x minus 1, and the distance from x to the right end point will be 1 minus x. This should be x minus negative 1. So that's really x minus negative 1. Okay. So, the epsilon that will work is epsilon equal to the minimum of those two values. X plus 1 and 1 minus x. So now that kind of makes sense looking at the picture, but a picture is not a proof. At least this picture is not a proof. But it is enough to give a good idea. So let's prove it. We could say, suppose that x is on the left side. So in particular, we could assume that x is less or equal to 0. Okay, so as a result, therefore, we could say epsilon is x plus 1. In the case that x is equal to 0, both of these are the same, because they'd both be 1, so this is still correct. Then, we could do our point x minus this epsilon is x minus x plus 1, which is maybe I should write this all in one line, otherwise I might run out of space. X minus epsilon is x minus x plus 1, which is minus 1. So that's the left end point. So that means that as long as x is more than, we could say, that we're requiring that. Therefore, x is more than negative 1, and x plus epsilon, well, that's x plus x plus 1, which is 2x plus 1. But that is, well, we could take, we could say that this is less or equal to 1 on this last step. This last step is possible because x is less or equal to 0. So the biggest that x could possibly be is 0. So if we take x to be 0, then 2x plus 1 is less or equal to 1. And because since we're taking this interval, it is definitely the case that x minus epsilon to x plus epsilon is a subset of negative 1 to 1. So since that's the case, because of these two endpoints, we've shown the result. Alternatively, suppose that x is on the right, that is to say that x is in the interval, that interval, and x is greater than or equal to 0, therefore we could select, according to this definition, we would select epsilon as 1 minus x. Okay. Then x minus epsilon is x minus 1 minus x. Which is 2x minus 1. And then the smallest that this could possibly be, we could say that this is greater than or equal to greater than or equal to negative 1. And this step from here to here is because of this assumption. Since x is greater than or equal to 0, the smallest x could possibly be a 0. So if we plug in 0 right there for x, that means that this is greater than or equal to negative 1. And x plus epsilon is x plus 1 minus x, which is 1. And therefore, x minus epsilon to x plus epsilon is again a subset of negative 1 to 1. And therefore, for all x in negative 1 to 1, because we handled the case less or equal to 0 and also greater than or equal to 0, because we handled that case, x minus epsilon to x plus epsilon is a subset of negative 1 to 1, which is what we wanted to show. part A. Okay, a local minimum, which is not a global minimum. Okay, so then the idea. I think a cubic will do it. Okay, so if we make that, so that can be x is 0. This one can be x is whatever we like. Say 1, and this one negative 1. Then a cubic that will do that is f of x is x plus 1 multiplied by x minus 1. So that's a cubic right there. This one is local. Min, which is not global. It's not global because it's obvious that cubics go all the way down, and that's a local min. B. This one's even easier. Again, just the idea. Any parabola will do. Local min, which is also a global min. So how about a standard parabola?